Welcome to Second Bull Run in Ultimate General Civil War, where I'm playing the Union Campaign, a major general difficulty with the JMP mod. With Second Bull Run, we're up to 3 corps now, and you'll see that I start to use my default division template, which is 2 infantry, a KEV, 2 artillery, and 1 skirmisher. I'll change it around a little bit depending on how I want things to deploy. Like other grand battles in the campaign up to this point, for the most part, units deploy in such a way that they reinforce the units that previously deployed, as opposed to later grand battles in the campaign where a corps will deploy along their own front and may operate independently. With that in mind, my best units are in 1st Corps, my next best in 2nd Corps, and my rookies are in 3rd Corps. Second Bull Run is a 3-day battle, or more specifically, there's a skirmish on the evening of the first day, and then large battles on day 2 and day 3. I do not like the total reset that's on day 3, where the AI takes away any ground that you took and makes you start all over again while tossing in 2 additional VPs to hold in the rear area. So I will be playing for a day 2 win to end it early and not play day 3. I took the Lorenz rifles and 20-pound Parrots with reputation points. My career points are 5 in Econ, 10 in Training, 6 in AO, and 4 each in Logistics and Recon. AI unit scaling is set to 1.2 for this battle. For Brawner's Farm, I'm going to sit back and let my guns take out the artillery and do a little damage to some infantry. Units in this phase go into day 2 with the same condition, so my guns will be out of ammo, but that's one less artillery unit that the AI will get to deploy on day 2. So my 3-star skirmisher unit here that's spotting has the Pickett's Salve Waves and Sharpshooter's perks, along with the Sharps M1859 rifle. I cannot recommend this combination enough. You should take these guys out for a test drive if you haven't built them yet. The Sharps rifle is the only long-distance skirmisher weapon with a high firing rate, which is 140. The Sharpshooter's perk has a 30% reload penalty, but the weapon's fire rate combined with the 10% reload bonus from the Zalwaves perk results in about a 120 final fire rate. The Skirmisher perk also gives a 20% effective range, which pushes out the 475-yard base weapon range to 570 yards. This particular stack of perks also gives them 100% accuracy, 50% to stealth, 60% to cover, 25% to speed, and 50% to spotting. They are an absolute killing machine. I'm going to use one of Napoleon's most successful strategies here on day 2 of the battle, and that is to divide and conquer and not let your enemy merge his forces together to bring his full force to bear on your army. So my guys are going to force march to the southwest corner of the battlefield and set up in the woods there to intercept both CSA corps that are coming in to reinforce Jackson. Once they are destroyed, my forces will be in position to flank Jackson from the southwest and push him off the Stony Ridge VP. In my opinion, Napoleon was one of the most innovative military strategists in history. His defeat at Waterloo was caused by many things, but one of those was that his enemies were finally able to merge their forces, and another was that they used Napoleon's own strategies and tactics against him, because each time the coalition lost in the past, they learned and incorporated his strategies and tactics into their own. Many of the strategies taught at West Point leading up to the war were based on Napoleon's victories in Europe, so both sides include those strategies during the war. When my 2nd Corps arrives, their infantry and guns will take up positions in the east, while their cav and skirmishers rush to link up with my 1st Corps ambush. By the way, I had forgotten this, but 4th Division and 1st Corps does not deploy on day 2, so I should have left that division empty. They do deploy if you go to the day 3. When my 3rd Corps deploys, their infantry guns will do the same and take up positions in the south and center of the battlefield while their cav and skirmishers come to help out 1st Corps. You should know that once you take the VP, you must hold it through the contested timer. If you click the Finish Battles button before the contested timer runs out, it will trigger day 3. I also find it goofy that your day 2 forces will still have the same condition on day 3, even though they rested overnight. The mod has actually cleaned that up in a lot of places throughout the campaign, but it's still at this battle. So enjoy the battle, and I'll comment during the battle report. I end up losing 6.5% of my forces. The AI lost 52.5% of its forces for a kill ratio of about 7-1. I end up taking a few more casualties than I needed because I got sloppy and used some brute force tactics in places that caused a high level of officers to be wounded that I won't get back until after Antietam, so maybe I should have gone to day 3. My 3-star skirmishers had over 2,400 kills, second only to my best 20-pound Parrot battery. I captured almost 2 brigades worth of Lorenz rifles, and I think this is the first time I've seen Tyler, Texas, and Harper's Ferries used by the CSA in this campaign. Thank you so very much for watching, and it's on the Crampton's Gap.